was a long time ago, in a hospital you know, when surgeons and internists worked on floors of their own. We begin our tale in the town of Procedure, where one thoracic surgeon will have a change in demeanor. Patients, young and old with chronic disease, relied on the medicine land doc's expertise. The realm of basic science had researchers galore, and the world of VA always shut down by four. Each world isolated, alone by itself, until one lost surgeon changed how we approach health. In a time before the consult, order, and page, a story of hubris unfolds on the stage.
Are saved.
Come watch us achieve this feat in the Department of Surgery.
This is surgery, this is surgery.
McBurney's point will get you the knife.
This is surgery, everybody hold your peace.
Students can't get a question right to save their life.
Mr. Updeed, now you can flee.
When you are on surgery,
I am the one shaving all of your hair. Razor blades leave your body bare.
I am the one hovering over your bed. Scalpel sharp and poopy glowing red.
This is surgery, this is surgery. Surgery, surgery, scalpel please, scalpel please.
Hail, recall home. Everyone hail to the monitor's song.
In this town.
Don't you love it how you never have to look your patients in the eye?
Rishi Reddy might cut you open wide and curse like a sailor in surgery.
In the OR, Rishi. I don't know how you survived a whole week on outpatient.
Thanks, Dr. Cherry. It's good to be back, but if I'm being honest, the change of scene was refreshing.
I love you, Rishi.
I love you, too.
Ha ha! I think we all share that sentiment, Rishi. You certainly are among the best of us.
No one in Procedure Town has cracked as many chests with an EBL of one.
And don't forget how much you cut down on OR costs by reusing your residents' tears as irrigation.
You know, I'd say that Drs. Kate Kraft and Justin Dimmock were being too kind, but it's all true. Anyway, enough about me, though. I have to show you my latest discovery. Mikey! Oh, Mikey! You all remember my best friend, Mikey Englesby. Drop it, Mikey! Who's a good boy? He found this while playing in the courtyard.
Yes, yes, yes!
Did he just bark the word yes?
It's the only word he knows. Isn't that right?
So, what is it?
I don't know. But it's new and exciting. Doesn't it make you wonder what else is out there?
No, not really. Can we get this show on the road already? I've got Mulholland's department to run.
Welcome! For those of you who don't know me, my name is Raj Mangrulkar, and I am the mayor of Procedure Town. You may be asking yourselves, how did a man who hasn't touched a scalpel since his M1 anatomy lab become the mayor of Procedure Town? Well, I'll respond to those queries in depth, of course, after I figure out what the hell to do about step one.
I'm sorry. What was that?
Oh no, they're on to us!
It was probably the wind.
there aren't any windows in here.
It's no use hiding me, your anxious side. Everyone knows behind the overinflated speeches and evasive answers, I live in constant fear of the next LCME accreditation.
Sorry about that. Why don't we get started? Here is Erica Newman to present some cases.
Thank you, Mayor Raj. There are no cases to report. Everyone was saved by procedural intervention with no morbidity or mortality. Great job, everyone.
Great.
Yes, Dr. Malai?
What about post-op complications?
Well, there was one complication, but it was anesthesia's fault.
It's always anesthesia's fault.
Yes, yes. What a great M&M. Okay. Let's see what else is on the agenda today.
Oh, no, we are way ahead of schedule. I hope no one's noticed this entire agenda could have been conveyed in one short email.
Sorry about that. How about we turn the mic over to Dr. Carol Bradford to touch base with some of the departments.
Thank you. I'm happy to welcome all of the surgical specialties, including dermatology and gynecology, as well as Procedure Town's more estranged relatives, anatomy, radiology, anesthesiology, pathology, and even emergency medicine. How are things in vascular surgery, Don Coleman?
One aorta! Ah, 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 ah!
You gonna finish that sentence, or?
I just had a really difficult patient last night. Carved him up like a pumpkin. But in the end, I repaired that aorta in under 90 minutes.
That's quite impressive.
Thanks, I'm pretty pumped about it. And now, so are my patient's lower extremities. I just love blood.
So you're, you're talking about pumpkins and then blood. What are you doing, like a Halloween thing?
I don't know what you're talking about. I said blood.
She's doing like a vampire thing, right? Dang. Gotta get back on those meds.
How about our colleagues in obstetrics and gynecology? Dave Marzano?
Yeah. I actually resected a record number of uteruses just yesterday.
Dave, how'd you even know where to look?
Oh. Who said that? Was it you, Cliff Craig? I bet you haven't seen a vagina in years.
Oh. Well, and outside a clinic, you're telling me that you have?
Oh. Why does everyone think that? I have had it with this disrespect. I'm leaving.
Don't you worry, I have just a speech for this.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we gather here today, I implore you to ask yourselves, can you realize your whole self? Because whether you think you can or you think you can't, you're probably right. Henry Ford, Raj Mangrulkar.
I'm so sorry. My arms are just so tired.
You should be sorry. We do our best to make med students feel welcome in the OR, and you still manage to screw up even the simplest of tasks.
Now, Dr. Skinner, let's give this poor med student another chance. She has been at this a very long time.
Has that been there the entire time?
Of course it has. You think we actually need you in here? Why don't you go change some dressings? And try not to contaminate anything on your way out.
Speaking of medical student incompetence, how about we touch base with our education committee? Allow me to introduce Karin Murazsko, the chair of neurosurgery.
Hello, everyone. I'm joined by my mentee, Madelyn Lew, and my dim-witted assistant, Kevin Tremper. Together, we surveyed the medical students who most recently completed the surgery clerkship. My notes, Tremper. We have zero reports of medical student mistreatment.
So it sounds like Dr. Orringer was on vacation, huh?
Unfortunately, there were some issues with the applied sciences component of the clerkship.
What are the applied sciences?
It's a pilot program that I helped design. It gives medical students experience in anatomy, anesthesia, pathology, and radiology during their clerkship.
And as I predicted, it has been a complete waste of time. Allow me to read a few testimonials from our not-so-anonymous feedback. Just like pathologist Scott Owens forcing another boat metaphor, this rotation is a sinking ship. And I would rather listen to John Williams read all of First Aid out loud.
But the early exposure to these areas is crucial to a well-rounded education. Students need to understand the value added by their colleagues. And who knows, there might even be a budding radiologist or even a pathologist among them.
Don't be ridiculous. Every competent surgeon should be entirely independent. Who needs a middleman to tell you to correlate clinically? I'm sure even the great Rishi Reddy would agree.
Sorry, you'll have to excuse me. I have some thinking to do.
Wow. You know, that is a great idea. Why don't we just all take some time to think and to reflect? Yeah, I want everyone to submit one page of writing into Canvas by tomorrow morning.
Hi.
Tomorrow morning, people. Tomorrow morning.
Not tonight, Carl. I'm not in the mood. Could you play me something more pitiful?
All right, people, everyone ready for timeout? Let's start with introductions. Karin, circulating nurse.
Jen Walji, plastic surgery.
Chris Sonaday, transplant surgery.
Khalid Hafez, urology.
Medical student, scrub tech.
Madelyn Lew, I'm just here to pick up the tissue sample.
Great, I don't see any surveyors here, so let's just skip the rest.
Rishi, what are you doing here?
Hey, Madelyn. This scalpel is the symbol of my craft. We use it to fix our patients, to excise disease, and even to threaten medical students when they break the sterile field. But is there more to me than this? I feel as lost as a surgeon trying to navigate the abdominal cavity with the med student driving the camera.
What are you trying to say?
Student, suction.
Forceps.
Army, Navy.
Rubber chicken.
Garden hose. Garden hose. Okay, we gotta have the garden hose tray open faster next time.
You're holding that chicken all wrong, Dr. Walji.
Son of a... All right, look, Rishi, I don't tell you how to do your job.
Do you guys ever feel bored?
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 I do.
Shut up! I do the same procedures, day in and day out. I'm tired of the endless incisions and the countless sutures.
Student, sterile field.
I mean, maybe I should take your applied sciences course. I could probably master those fields in, what, like a few hours?
Hey, those specialists train almost as long as you do, Rishi.
I could never get tired of the sound of a cracking sternum. I even made it my ringtone.
Yeah. Sonnenday gets a half-chub just thinking about the smell of burning flesh under a bovie.
See, that's the thing. I haven't pitched a tent at the sight of a pulsing bowel in months.
You know, you should get that checked out. I mean, I can take a look at it for you if you want.
Where's the challenge? The excitement?
Don't be silly, Rishi. Your patients depend on you. You trained for years to be able to help them in their times of need.
But there has to be something beyond these four walls. I mean, look at me. I'm on a break between cases, and I'm here, in the OR.
If you're looking for a thrill, you could watch an OB-GYN try to use a scalpel.
Or identify a ureter.
Yeah.
You guys are missing the point. I've done all of surgery. There just has to be something else out there. I just don't know what it could be.
From T1 to T12, in the thorax I'm the best, and my talents are renowned far and wide. When it comes to transplants in your overnight, I'm the one that you want in your side. With the slightest little flick of my well-trained wrist, I can enter your chest cavity. With a wave of my knife, tumors I excise, and all the med students quiver at my feet. Yet day after day, it's the same routine, and I grow so weary of the chest CTs. And I, Rishi, thoracic king, have grown so tired of the same damn thing. What destiny do I have in store? A future with only closed doors. There's something out there far from this floor. A calling to do something
more. Where is he going? Gosh, I mean, the best surgeon in Procedure Town has really gone to his head.
Oh, shoot. Do you guys think we use too much force?
Oh, that's just my ringtone.
Oh, hey, thank goodness.
Did you get that? It could be a transplant. Yeah, my phone is somewhere deep, deep inside this gown.
Okay.
Deep breaths.
Is it here?
But a patient's life could be on the line.
I get it. You're some fancy schmancy urologist that saves lives, and I'm just a urologist that plays with dicks all day. Yellow. Oh, yeah, I'll tell Dr. Sonaday right away. They said you just got off the list.
The list? Which one? The liver? Kidney? Pancreas?
No, the study that gives away the Apple Watches.
Oh my God, yes! You have no idea how long I've been waiting. Oh my God. Oh. Come on, let's finish this up before the med students take them all.
Madelyn, there you are. I need your help with these plans. I tried to get Tremper to help, but he's glued to his crossword or whatever he's doing.
I was just talking with Rishi. He seems a bit down. He says he's bored with surgery.
Bored? Why am I not surprised? For a man who mastered his sixth choice of residency, he should be grateful he even has the chance to practice. I am the first woman to chair an academic neurosurgery department in the country, and yet I continue to work my fingers to the bone. And for what? To be in the shadow of a man who leads a clerkship that drew a whopping 5 students to general surgery?
You're being too hard on him. Rishi works hard and he cares about his patients.
Oh, sure, he cares. It's a wonder when a man cares about his patients, but for women, it's expected. I didn't roll my way to the top of the department by simply caring. No, I obtained an Ivy League education, performed groundbreaking research, and led several national societies.
I know, Dr. Murazsko, but things are changing. Medicine's not a boys' club anymore. We even have lactation pods where residents can breastfeed and shame privately. They even gave us a seminar about egg freezing.
Oh, Madelyn, come here. Those are baby steps. You're so naive. What would you do without me? You should consider freezing your eggs. You need to prioritize your career from the start if you're going to be the talented surgeon I know you can be.
Actually, I was meaning to talk to you about that. I'm not sure that the operating room is the right place for me. I was thinking that pathology...
Pathology? You can't be serious. You really want to spend your days in the company of dead bodies and indistinguishable shades of pink?
What can I say? 50 Shades of Pink is my favorite book. And I just can't get enough of that formaldehyde smell.
You'll never earn the respect you deserve if you choose pathology. You'll spend the rest of your career as a faceless name at the bottom of a results report.
But my peers do respect me. I was even awarded...
Besides, you're a people person. You're meant to care for frightened patients face to face.
Can I get a word in?
What did you say? Are you talking back to me?
I can care for patients in pathology. They need pathologists to establish diagnoses, report on surgical margins, and so much more.
If you are seriously considering pathology, then I have failed you as a mentor. And I don't fail. Tremper, grab Dr. Lewis' seat so I can talk some sense into her.
Whenever I meet someone less dexterous than I,
and let's face it, who is it?
Less dexterous than I, my surgeon's heart tends to start to bleed. And when women ask for mentorship, I simply start to lose my shit because I know exactly what they need. I know you're still unsure, but you have gotta trust your old mentor. Don't worry, I know that you'll love to soar. Just take it slow. Before you know, you'll be my protege. I'll make you my protege. I'll teach you the proper whip when you run that stitch. Little ways to sew and tie. I'll show you which clips to choose when those oozers ooze. Everything that really counts to do surgery. Ooh, as my little protege, I'll teach you to yell at scrubs like Mulholland does. Know which instruments to throw. So let's start, cause you've got an awfully long way to go. Don't be averted by the personalities. Helps to think of raking in the higher salaries. Now that I've chosen you to be my wonder, my surgical successor, there is nobody better. Not when you are my protege, apprentice of surgery. And with first assist from me, you'll make history. Your career will start to fly. If you want to be on top, you should become my protege. Shy. La 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 la. You're gonna be my protege.
I think I've made my point, have I not? I hope that this is the last I hear of this pathology nonsense.
But...
Trevor! What did I tell you about eating the Dermabond? Ugh. Excuse me while I stop this simpleton before he accidentally shoots up propofol. I'll see you at Grand Rounds?
Yeah, I'll see you there.
Tremper, put the bear hugger down! How many times have I told you to keep your little Tremper out of there?
Where are we? I've never seen these elevator doors before. Oh, no need to sterilize, Mikey. I wonder where they lead. Should we find out?
Yes! Yes!
I'm confused. Is that a yes or a no? Oh, you'd never say no to your best friend, would you? Or anyone, for that matter. Okay, well, I'm going with or without you. I've been looking for something new, and this could be it.
You look lost. Do you need directions?
Someone should put a bell on you. Why is it so dark in here?
I can help with that. We don't want to wake the pediatric patients before rounds.
Wait, before? It's 9 a.m. Didn't you finish rounding hours ago? What kind of place is this?
Why, this is Medicine Land.
Christ, you're multiplying.
I'm Anita Hernandez, and these are my colleagues, Brad Dyke and Tamara Gay. We're pleased to be the first to welcome you here.
Welcome me to what exactly?
To a place where internists, pediatricians, family docs, neurologists, and psychiatrists come together to deliver the most splendid, evidence-based, patient-centered care.
Internists? Pediatricians? Care?
The very best!
But why tell you when we can show you? Let's give our guest a warm Medicine Land welcome. Everyone!
This place is flanking amazing. What the? Why can't I say flank?
This is a family-friendly environment. We censor all offensive terms for their medical counterparts.
What?
That's right, Dr. Monrad. Just wait until you meet the big man. He's the smartest, nicest, cutest doc in all of medicine. His name is Cyril Grum.
Oh, Cyril! I know him!
We all do. I think I hear him coming now.
Merry clerkships, everyone. I'm sorry, I have to step in here. You're doing a Christmas thing, right?
I'm sorry, I don't understand the question.
What do you mean you don't understand the question? I mean, you're wearing that. I'm sorry, what'd you say? So, you're wearing this stuff, and you're telling me you're not doing a Christmas thing. I just don't get it. I just don't get it. Yeah. Keep it together, buddy. Keep it together, buddy.
Oh, look, Cyril, a new face.
Who's this? What's your name, friend?
What's my name? I haven't had to introduce myself in years. Rishi Reddy, thoracic surgeon.
Pleased. This is my right hand, Laura Mariani. So, what brings you to Medicine Land?
I accidentally stumbled onto your elevator. I gotta say, this place is like nothing I've ever seen.
Isn't it something? We have a diverse practice with over 800 faculty members. I'm a bit embarrassed to ask, but what exactly does a surgeon do?
What don't we do? We remove infected gallbladders, transplant organs, and even restore the confidence of impotent men with inflatable penis pumps.
What kind of man needs a penis pump? Certainly not I. World-renowned cardiologist Kim Eagle. I mean, we're talking Eiffel Tower, you know, a big bent.
Hey, do you have a card?
Yeah.
For a patient of mine.
Interesting. Well, we have our own way of managing disease around here. Why don't I walk you through our typical day?
Lead the way.
The cornerstone of our work is the patient interview. Here we see Dr. Amy Rosinski approaching hour three of a psychiatric history with a most interesting patient.
Wait, hour three? I could have lobotomized the patient in half that time.
So, the name's Joel Heidelbaugh. I was just telling Dr. Rosinski over here that my book, Case Files, Family Medicine, won the Pulitzer Prize.
So that's actually his daughter's volleyball trophy? He's demonstrating profound narcissistic personality disorder, with just a touch of delusional disorder.
Excellent work, Dr. Rosinski.
Thank you.
Shall we?
Yeah.
After taking a detailed history, we perform a thorough exam. Let's watch as top neurologist Doug Gelb performs the mental status exam.
I'm going to assess your cognitive function with a simple question. What's the difference between an apple and an orange? If the apple is the last three presidents, and the orange is how many nickels there are in $1.37.
February?
No, you have dementia.
What? Dementia?
Yes, but with any luck, we can get you to see a specialist in, about 9 months or so.
9 months? Please tell me dementia isn't progressive, degenerative, or horribly impairing.
Yeah, you have a lot to learn. Let's keep moving. Dr. Stojan, it's nice to see you. Would you mind showing our guest here how we approach a differential diagnosis?
Not at all. We were just talking about a 7-year-old girl with abdominal pain.
She hasn't pooped in days, so constipation is culprit number 1, 3, and 4.
What's number 2?
Something this patient desperately needs.
Excellent. What else we got?
You have to consider gastroenteritis and appendicitis.
Yes, I love it. What else?
I mean, she's only 7, but we should rule out aortic aneurysm anyway.
Now things are heating up.
Cancer?
Always have to consider it.
How about lead poisoning?
Yes, don't stop.
Oh, I know. Familial Mediterranean fever.
That was deliciously esoteric.
I'll have what she's having.
I'm uncomfortable. Let's keep going.
At the end of the day, our passion is developing longitudinal relationships with our patients using compassion and open, honest communication.
Yeah, but don't take our word for it. Let patient favorite Tom Sisson demonstrate with one of his most inspiring patients.
It's so good to see you. How are you doing?
I'm a bit worn, but I have you and the amazing staff at Michigan Medicine to keep me going.
Unfortunately, I have some bad news. Your tests show that the cancer has spread, and we'll need to admit you to the hospital.
That is bad news, but I understand.
Wait a minute. I remember you.
Dr. Reddy? I haven't seen you in years. Everyone, this is the amazing surgeon that took such good care of me years ago.
How have you been? Hey, what's happening? What is going on?
You should get some rest. Hey, let's get you into a room.
Where are you going?
Bye, Dr. Reddy. It was so good to see you again.
Well, there you have it. Any questions?
Sorry, what?
I said, do you have any questions?
Yeah, I do have one, actually. How'd you get to be the one in charge around here?
Well, I'm glad you asked. Have a seat, and I'll tell you the story of how Medicine Land came to be. You all know our motto for training doctors through and through. You know it takes some hard work, and it does unless you groom. But now it's time to tell it to those fresh new docs out there in need of a wise attending who had a little Sanjay Gupta flair. Have you heard of the all-benevolent doctors? Those doe-eyed, brilliant docs for all. We don't just answer you world questions to make polished physicians. No, we read to master all of medicine.
I'm gonna take you back to Galenian times, 200 AD. An American doc named Cyril, working in the wards in the humble town of Ann Arbor, Michigan.
You mean that wise guy Cyril Grum?
That's right, that wise guy built our land.
He built our land?
Indeed, I came from a clinic of fame in the state to the south. I ran those wards and always won the game. Then I, Groom, started searching for a place to settle down where I could share my craft, and Ann Arbor was that town.
Wow, he chose his students here to make in his own image. That makes perfect sense.
Right here I found a home and showed trainees how it's done. I gave this place a whole new look and made endless surrounding fun.
Hey, Groom showed us how to care for the patients of our lands. He has commanded putting the sick first and healing them with our hands.
Forever, so doing something with my hands sounds pretty swell. I'm interested.
Now, many students didn't grasp the onus of the task. If they were to be the ones patients need, then they would have to read everything that they could find. But Groom said,
this is no lie, I use the stuff all the time, and it's made me the best. As a young resident, I read mountains of text, kept on where I went, and learned how to care at Cleveland Clinic.
The promised land?
Paradise for the white coats, nothing but scopes and stents as far as the eye can see.
I have an impotent penis.
Okay. Well, anyway. Now comes the part of our story that gets a little bit sad. As those darn millennials came, reading made people mad. Students were caught by a crazy fad. Groom feared would test their faith.
They never touch their textbooks now. They just read up to date. Oh God. Why is everything online? How come the library doesn't have any books? They'll have no proof they are learning the truth or not. They'll just watch everything 2X. Oh, I'll never sell another copy of I Am Essentials. No!
Cyril Grum almost retired over what he believed in. But his followers? We couldn't let him go. So he led us to the third floor of Taubman, a dazzling place at the University of Michigan called Medicine Land. And here, under Dr. Groom's complete censorship of the internet, we read! And now, it's his job to teach us what the online med ed videos never could!
Have you heard of the all-benevolent doctor? The dull-eyed, brilliant doctor? He's gonna do something impossible, make reading cool again. Cause Cyril Grum, the doctor, is
now we'll even throw in a free new Q bank.
All benevolent.
Wow, this place is the shunt.
Oh, and we haven't even shown you the best part.
What is that?
It's a note. No detail is too irrelevant for our documentation.
Oh, son of a breach.
Cyril, we really should get going. We have to teach the students about nephritic syndrome. And that will take all day.
No, Laura. I so appreciate you and your love of glomerular disease.
What? It's glomerular.
Or that's what I said, glolululemon disease.
Glomerular.
Yes, Laura. Glow-moop-dee-doodle. Well, anyway, it was nice to meet you, Rishi. I hope you enjoyed your visit to Medicine Land. Toodaloo.
Medicine Land is a special place, but it could use a surgeon's touch. I should get back to Procedure Town. I'll see you soon, Medicine Land.
Yes!
Not now, Mikey. As I was saying, in order to be a successful thoracic surgeon, you must have delicate size 7 hands like I, Mark Oringer.
Oh my gosh!
Dr. Fix, you have gorilla hands! Those will never do.
Should I get plastic surgery on my hands to make them smaller? What do you think, Dr. Knoll?
You guys are weird.
It's a boring conversation.
But guess what I have for you, Mikey? A branch! You love branches, don't you? Yeah. Go get it! Man, good thing I had that branch in my pocket. I ran out of dog treats and meaningless administrative titles.
He was a good branch director. Yeah. You're such a good boy.
You know, Dr. Mahan, I think you might be trying to tell us something.
Really?
Yes!
Okay, let's see. All right, let's see. Two words. The monster?
Rishi Reddy.
Yeah, okay.
I'm getting some sort of shaft.
Okay. Up the shaft? Down the shaft? Up and down the shaft?
Maybe down the shaft.
In the hole?
Why is he in a shaft now? What? Oh, he's sleeping. Oh, is he
compromising position? On his knees? Rishi's on his knees.
Come on, Mikey, do better. Come on. We need something else. I got it. Rishi's falling down the old town well.
Oh, my God.
No, you idiots. He's clearly trying to tell us that Rishi stumbled onto an elevator that's taken him to a mysterious, previously unknown to us floor of the hospital.
Yes.
Oh, of course. Wait, yes. So Rishi's gone?
Yes.
Yeah, you're a good boy, Mikey. Let's go tell Miraj.
Wait, has anyone seen Rishi? Because it's Slow's day in the cafeteria, and I know that barbecue's his favorite.
Grand Rounds was supposed to start an hour ago. Where is Rishi? I need him. I'm just an elected dean. I can't make decisions without a focus group and an anonymous survey.
Rishi, Mikey just told us that Rishi fell down a well and hasn't been seen since.
Is that true, Mikey?
Yes.
This is an emergency. Code red, everyone. Code ready.
Oh, my God.
Rishi! Oh, Rishi, thank God.
Am I too late for Grand Rounds?
No, you're right on time.
Good. Guys, I have to tell you about my latest discovery. It's called Medicine Land. Mm-hmm. It's a place in this hospital where doctors fix patients without scalpels, bovies, or staple guns.
That's preposterous. How on earth do they fix them then?
With this.
What is it?
It's called a stethoscopy.
I'm gonna have to step in here. Are we just gonna pretend like that doesn't look like Christmas tree? Okay.
As I was saying, it's called a stethoscopy. Doctors use them to listen to patients' insides in Medicine Land.
Is that really necessary? I get all the information I need with a gentle percussion and an arbitrary spot in the abdomen.
Plus, Rishi, how would you even use a stethoscopy?
I'm glad you asked, Dr. Wakefield. I invited a medical student to demonstrate on a standardized patient. This should tell you everything you need to know about Medicine Land.
Hi. I have been very busy, deep into my M4 electives. Why did I have to fly all the way back from Bangkok for this?
I believe I can answer that. Hi, I'm Helen Morgan, and this exercise is only offered in select locations.
And what's the purpose of it?
To prove that you can speak English and wash your hands.
Why did I have to pay $1,300 for it?
Because medical education has been turned into an industry by large corporations bent on exploiting young adults already burdened by thousands of dollars of debt. But we give you free lunch, so it basically evens out.
This sounds like a scam. It definitely sounds like a scam.
Listen, I'm gonna be real with you. You need to pass this in order to graduate medical school, match into residency, and board in medicine. But no pressure.
You may now begin.
Knock, knock.
Come in.
Hello. I am the medical student that will be taking care of you today. Are you... Mrs. Smith? What was that?
Ooh. Sorry, we had to dock a point because you forgot to verify how the patient likes to be addressed. She goes by Miss Smith.
No, I... Okay. Miss Smith, how can I take care of you to... Well, again?
Oh, you didn't establish rapport? Knowing that Miss Smith didn't have trouble finding parking is crucial. Without that rapport, how is she going to feel comfortable disclosing her devastating alcohol addiction later on?
Yeah, that makes sense. Mrs. Smith, how can I take care of you today?
Thank you, Dr. Bergstrom. The cold February wind chills my soul. I haven't slept in weeks. I've been haunted. Haunted by the memory of lost love. By the fairy-like touch of his fingertips caressing my face. Oh, how I ache for him. Oh, much like this ache I have in my abdomen. Also, it burns when I pee.
This can't be real. This Please. Can't be real.
Please stay in character.
Okay. Let's move on to the review of systems. Why again?
She quit smoking. You should have reinforced that positive behavior.
No, she literally just lit a cigarette. Are you gaslighting me? What is going on here?
Multiple questions.
Why now? Are you serious?
Closed-ended question.
No! I'm done with this! I should have gone to Ross!
Well, I don't think I could have explained Medicine Land any better myself. Any questions?
I have to go to run to tinker with my model trains, so I think we only have time for one more question. Oh, I have a question. What is the point of Medicine Land anyways?
Great question, Mayor Raj. When I was in Medicine Land, I ran into a patient I took care of years ago. When she was under my care, you could hardly tell she was sick. But now, she looks absolutely awful. I don't know what those hacks in Medicine Land are doing, but I know that I can do much better. With our surgeons and my supervision, all of those patients would be completely cured. So, I propose that we infiltrate Medicine Land and seize control of the wards.
Yeah.
Well, how would we manage that?
Easy. Head over at normal rounding time, 5 a.m. Medicine Land docs don't start rounding until 9. Then we'll take care of those patients as if they were our very own.
So you want us to take care of patients on another service?
Yeah, that's right.
Even though we don't know who they are, what they have, or how to use a stethoscopy?
Uh-huh.
Placing us and the hospital at devastating risk of malpractice lawsuits?
Yep.
Am I the only one that thinks this is a terrible idea?
Yeah, I think you are. This plan is foolproof. Count me in, Rishi.
I'm with Dr. Hughes. It reminds me of my favorite surgical commandment. Measure never and cut as many times as you need.
That's the spirit, Dr. Stukin. Who else is with me?
Yeah!
Excellent. You'll find stethoscopies outside in the hall for you to practice on. Let's get to work. Not so fast, you three. Yes, you. You're all coming with me. Michelle Daniel, Mike Cole, Rob Huang. I have a job for you three before you go back to the emergency department. There's a man in Medicine Land. His name is Cyril Grum. He's the leader there, and I need him gone if this plan is gonna work.
Well, right away.
As you wish.
Anything for the great thoracic king.
He's about yay high, is dressed entirely in red, and is absolutely adorable. You'll find him in his workshop.
Find the red man! Find the red man!
That's right, Mike. We're going to find the man in red.
I know you three have some sort of deal with Perry Pernicano. Keep him out of this. I don't want him interfering with my plans.
Of course, Dr. Reddy. We would never disobey your wishes.
Never!
Good. Now, run along.
Yeet!
I swear, if Dr. Okonlami invites me to one more of his dumb basketball games.
Madelyn, Murazsko, just the people I was looking for.
We were actually looking for you, too. What are your plans for Medicine Land? It sounds like a hostile takeover.
Me? Hostile? Never. This is going to be a peaceful collaboration. Dr. Murazsko, I could use your robot surgeon army.
My babes, badass biddies, and elite surgeons. I knew a cohort of surgical residents capable of working nonstop would come in handy after last year's resident revolution.
Yes, I could also use your studs, too.
The studs are an obsolete model. Trumper over there is one of them.
Mance, 1979. Hottest bod.
They're quite...
Oh, my back!
Defective.
Wait. So, it's a cohort made entirely of women? Whoa, I get so awkward around women. I don't know how to talk to girls. We're surrounded. It's bad. I can't do it.
Rishi, you work with women all the time.
I do what now?
Newman, Coleman, Hardiman, they're all women and some of your most talented colleagues.
No. How was I supposed to know that they're all women? Their names literally all end in man. All day I'm just surrounded by men, okay? It's just too complicated. I don't know what's going on underneath the scrub caps and the surgical gowns.
All right, Rishindra. I know you think women are inferior physicians. Won't your emotions get in the way? Is that the patient's blood or your period blood? Well, I have had it. This army is going to show you that female physicians are just as capable as men.
Medicine Land is in good hands if your robots are half as talented as Dr. Newman. So thank you for loaning your army to the cause.
You're welcome.
Madelyn, I need your help too.
Me?
Yes. I'm going to need your help interpreting all the tissue specimens that are going to come from a whole ward of new surgical patients.
Don't encourage her. Madelyn is my protege, which means she will be a surgeon. She should be practicing her suturing, not biopsies.
But...
No, I must be on my way. I need to put some finishing touches on the babes before I send them off to Medicine Land. Come along, Tremper.
That reminds me. I have to change, too. It's time to put the red in Reddy. You'll see, Madelyn.
Rishi, this is a
It's a fantastic idea. Think of all the patients we're gonna save.
But I don't...
I'll see you on the wards.
Nobody ever listens to me. And I have damn good things to say. Rishi's too proud to see that this plan is totally insane. And Murazsko refuses to accept that pathology is my passion. I just wish I could get her to understand. Look at me with a thousand decks stained in pink and blue. You won't find a surgeon knowing me. The lab's where I'd spend my time. Now I see that if I were to biopsy myself, I would find a new cell line. One.
Tremper. Turn the babes and studs on. They need a test run. Oh, my. Is this the best we have? None of them look fit to be surgeons. I can smell the fear of procedures on this one.
Please don't make me suture. I just want to write my notes in peace.
And this one takes after you, Tremper. He'd prefer to spend his time on the other side of the drape.
How else am I going to get some Sudokus done?
You! Do you even care about definitively managing patients?
Why would I care about definitive management when I could place a chest tube and call surgery from the ED?
Lord help me. This one looks more promising. He has the ego and narcissistic tendencies of a surgeon.
But I only watch myself sing Skinny Love once before bed every night.
All right, Tremper, turn the other babes and studs on. If they look anything like this four, they need a lot of work.
About the girl all the time. Wow, wow. East side to the west side, pushing fat rides, it's no surprise. She got tricks in the stash, stacking up the cash, fast when it comes to the gas. By no means average, it's on when she's got to have it. Baby, you're a perfect 10. I wanna get in, can I get down so I can? I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Bag it up.
I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Bag it up, girl.
I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Bag it up.
I like the way you work it.
No diggity.
I got to bag it up.
Very good. Feel good.
Feel good. Feel good.
Nasty.
Nasty. Nasty.
Yeah.
Too dirty to clean my act up.
Yeah.
If you ain't dirty, you ain't here to party.
Oh, I'm overdue. Give me some room. Coming through. Paid my dues. In the mood. Me and my girls gonna shake the room. DJ spinning. Show your head. Let's get dirty. That's my jam. I need that to get me off. Sweating till my clothes come off. It's close to speakers are pumping. Still jumping 6 in the morning. Table dancing, glasses for fashion. No questions, time for some action. Table just up. Now to a roll.
is a little bit of old school for you. That goes a little something like this. I always tried to be the flyest kid in the block. The popular one with the rising stock. So that's when I had this bright idea.
For now the party of the month.
Now the party of the year. All the fine girls couldn't turn it down. Now all I gotta do is get my parents out. Should I send them to a movie?
Nah, send them to a show.
Let me think. It's gotta be long though. I said, Mom, Dad, yo, why you sitting home? It's a Friday night. Have you seen Aunt Jo? And don't worry about staying out too long. Don't fuss over me. I'll be fine alone. Have a good time. The doorbell rings because the party's here. I'm cranking up the stereo like it's New Year's. Walking around the house like who's the man?
Ain't nobody do it like Eric can.
People all around, you got to.
I'll get it.
Everyone together, sing it loud.
I'll get it.
Jump all around, come on.
I'll get it.
What?
I'll get it.
Say it again.
I'll get it.
People all around, you got to.
I'll get it.
From the left to the right, make noise.
I'll get it.
Here we go now, come on.
I'll get it.
What?
I'll get it.
What?
I'll get it.
What?
Na 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 na.
Talk about, you know, the finer things in life. Check it out.
Ooh, that dress so scandalous, and you know another couldn't handle it. So you're shaking that thing like who's the ish, with a look in your eyes so devilish. You like to dance all the hip hop spots, and you cruise to the cruise like an actor dot. Not just urban, she liked the pop, cause she was living la vida loca. She had dumps like a truck, thighs like wah, baby, move your butt. Sing it again. She had dumps like a truck. Thighs like wah, all night long. Let me see that thong. Baby, that thong. I like it when the beat go. Baby, make your booty go. That thong.
Still hear your voice when you sleep next to me. I still feel your touch in my dream. Forgive me my weakness, but I don't know why. Without you, it's hard to
nobody saw that. These robots are nowhere close to being ready for the takeover. They do need a lot of work. I better get started right away.
Yeah, Gina?
What a great turnout for this optional lecture.
Wait, this is optional?
So help me God, I will force-feed you contrast if you try to leave. Doug, Leslie Quinn, always a pleasure. Kate Klein, nice of you to grace us with your presence.
Hello, Perry. If you don't mind, the medical students and I are going to play a little game.
Name that nodule? I love that one.
Not quite. So, Perry Pernicano can be a little intimidating. The only way that I can keep my cool around him is by drinking heavily. And so I have a boozy little game for us to play while he lectures.
All right, students, let's get started with a Perry Pernicano specialty, the chest radiograph. Students, what do you see?
I see an airway.
I see bones. And a cardiac?
Oh, do you see a diaphragm and everything else too?
Yeah!
Use your imagination. The least you can do is unsuccessfully rule out an underlying malignancy.
Why don't I take a crack? I may be a simple neuroradiologist.
Yes,
but
Doug, you are simple.
Nobody asked you, Leslie. Anyway, I still know a thing or two about the chest. There are some dense opacities in the lung bases on both sides, likely pneumonia versus atelectasis.
Those are breasts.
Ah, yes, I see. I do envy the person who gets to correlate clinically, you know what I mean?
I didn't realize you were blind, Dog, although it does explain that pathetic read and why you always leave your socks lying around the house, period, new paragraph. That chest x-ray is entirely normal.
Oh, Leslie, you spoil all the fun. You know I love to watch med students squirm as they grasp for abnormal findings.
Dr. Pernicano!
God, what do you three want? I'm already up to my eyeballs and pan scans from your emergency department.
And we are so grateful for those impressions.
But this isn't about imaging!
No!
This is big! As big as Rishi Reddy's ego!
I'm listening.
Rishi is planning a takeover of another department's ward.
Oh, why am I not surprised? Rishi Reddy thinks he can do any job around. Typical surgeon.
He asked us to kidnap their leader and bring him to Procedure Town!
Students, this lecture is over. You may go.
Yes!
Woo! Scapes!
And why, pray tell, would he ask the three of you for help?
Because... I don't know.
Honestly, I have no idea. I have the maturity of a medical student, and Michael Cole is literally tweaking 24/7.
Grum! Wait, one more! Grum!
Michelle, he's stuck again. Can you...
Do that thing you do.
Badass.
God, I love doing that.
What's a groom? It's the man that Rishi wants us to capture.
I know that look. You've got something cooking, don't you, Pear?
Those surgeons up in Procedure Town don't give us the respect we deserve. You heard Murazsko at last week's M&M.
Who needs a middleman?
Well, we're gonna put them in their place. We'll put Reddy, Murazsko, and all those other goons in Procedure Town in their place.
So, what do you plan to do?
Groom!
Yes, Dr. Cole. We're going to take this groom hostage, and those goons in Procedure Town won't know what hit them. Those surgeons don't respect us, henchmen. Think my impressions waste their time. Can't tell light gray from dark gray. Without my films, they'd all cut blind.
Without his films, they'd all cut blind.
Rishi won't know what hit him. I'll nab Cyril and bring him here for some invasive imaging. Lay down on my table, I'll shoot my x-ray beams. Just take a deep breath and hold so I can see everything I please. I can read the history, I will ignore it, it's true. Oh, in your scans I see your guts laid bare. Patients really are so ugly. All your darkest secrets too. Push the contrast, all the contrast. Let's give them all AKI. Cause without my films they'd all cut blind.
Without his films they'd all cut blind.
Little bored with your life, huh, Rishi? Now you want to go and learn medicine too? Well, I can see through this power grab. Can't keep secrets from me, because medicine goes through Grum. It's the Grum, it's the Grum, it's the Grum I need. For my scheming to work, bring that old Grum to me. Come on, boys. Once you bring Dr. Grum here, bring that medicine king to me. Yes. Are you ready?
Are you ready?
Rishi Reddy.
Rishi Reddy.
Radiation Central.
Radiation Central.
Attenuation Central.
Attenuation Central.
Opacification Central. Can you feel it? I'm scheming, I'm scheming, I'm scheming tonight. Those surgeons will see I'm right. And if they don't, they'll be sorry, 'cause without my films, they'd all carte blanche. Blanche.
To medicine, he was looking for something new. He caught the best, better than all the rest, and away from the OR he flew. When he came upon a strange new place where docs didn't anesthetize, now they ran into beds and passed out meds into this thing called empathize. So he asked them how the whole thing worked, because he didn't want to presume. And they did declare behind the whole affair was a doc named Cyril Grum. Cyril told him, "Welcome, son, we were just rounding now. And if you want to stay and watch a work day, then we could probably show you how." But Rishi turned away privately, and he thought to himself with a grin, "I could run this place, say sure and brace, 'cause I'm the best there's ever been." Residents of Procedure Town heard Reddy's madcap scheme. They were skeptical at first, of course, because it sounded like a dream. But Rishi calmly soothed their fears and said, "We'll soon begin. I done told you once, you son of a bitch, I'm the best it's ever been."
It's time for act two.
You know what that means, Ari. It's time to open with an upbeat number.
You like something to be happy right now. No, it's not. I'm sorry, Katie. I missed my cue.
Was it speaker out again?
I'm sorry. That's, anyway. Rana, are we about to start the second act now?
Yeah. I wonder what song they're gonna play.
Oh my god.
They wouldn't. It's so hokey.
Yeah.
It's not even Christmas anymore.
Nope.
I just want the best in training. Make a good dog out of me. take great care of patients, even in pathology. Train me where the leaders go, somewhere I can call my home. Nothing else will do.
I'm starting to think that maybe this isn't such a good idea. Maybe we should just go back. Never mind.
We're here. Let's get ready to save some lives. Guys and gals, I learned recently, what happened to all that chutzpah from Grand Rounds?
Lame.
Spam is more interesting than this.
Oh, no. Mayor Raj, I think we could use one of your patented pep talks.
Oh, I thought you'd never ask. Our lives contract and relax in cycles. More often than not, you see, we are in a state of peristalsis, but many of us still strain to push out good results.
Here we go.
I have two wishes for you all during this takeover. Peristalsis and defecation.
Oh, we're losing them. We're losing them.
After you refill yourselves, allow some time for peristalsis to occur. Then, and only then, I want you to relieve yourselves. Whether that's in a bedside commode or the bathroom that a medical student followed you into.
Yeah, bring it home, baby!
I truly believe that if we all peristalsis together, we can form a massive movement. Unlike anything that has happened before.
May you all keep yourselves emotionally isolated during this takeover. No.
Okay, all right, fam. This is the moment we spent literally minutes preparing for. Let's get out there and show those medicine land docs how surgeons care. Woo!
Yeah.
Hey, Rishi, you coming?
That's what she said. I'm sorry. There's a patient I have to see.
Let's see, all right. We have Sally here. She's 8. Well, this should be a breeze. How sick could a kid be?
Oh gosh, so many overnight events. Vital signs are unstable, labs are whack, not good.
Oh, good morning there, sweet peas. Would you mind elaborating on your very important presentation for us?
Spare no detail. We want to know everything.
Holy Karina. Who are you?
Oh, well, we're Sally's moms.
Oh, well, could you come back later? We're rounding.
But we wake up at 3 every morning just to be here when the physicians stop by. That's the whole point of family-centered rounds.
Family? I remember my family. My wife, Casey, my son. Derek? No, Tim?
But Dr. Hughes, you don't have any children.
That's right, honors.
Not to be rude, but who are you?
I'm Jeff Coslow, and this here is Dave Hughes, and these are the medical students.
Ah, nice to meet you.
Please continue your presentation. We love having all of the numbers. We don't know what they mean, but we will panic about them anyway.
Okay. Well, your kid has something called a diabetes ketosis and doses disease.
That's cute. I guess we can't all be honor students. But the good old DKA, that's actually kind of a tough one. Could you give us 1 second?
Retract.
Bone saw?
IVH monitor. Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3, X-Lap!
So, after conferring with my colleagues over here, I have some news to share. Your son...
Oh, she's a girl?
We can fix that, too. Your son is not going to be okay. He's going to be more than okay when we're done with him. We've decided that the best course of action is to perform a Whipple.
A whoozy-watsy?
Well, you see, so the pancreas is the problem, so we'll just cut it out.
Oh, no, that seems a bit extreme.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't realize you had 7 to 10 years of highly specialized education to make that decision.
Oh, no. It's not that. It's just that I'm just a little...
If the surgery clerkship oral exam has taught me anything, it's to always confidently take the patient to the OR.
Get those horses back in the barn! We have our questions!
I want to talk to you about this WebMD article!
Hello, I'm Dr. Sam Kempner from OB-GYN. Are you Mr. Davis?
Can you help me with my prostate, doc?
Yeah, I can help you with your prostate, an organ I definitely knew existed before this moment, but let me go get something.
I just got a page that says, MD aware? What am I supposed to be aware of exactly?
That's right. You get NPO. Yes, you get NPO. You all get NPO!
Ew. Did you hear that?
Yeah, but where did it come from?
Can you please tell my husband a toilet seat gave him gonorrhea?
Do you have any more apple juice and graham crackers?
Can I get someone to fill out this FMLA paperwork?
There's too many of them! We're outnumbered!
What do we do?
Run!
You guys mind if I play some music while we pre-round?
Great idea, Dr. Kaufman. How was your weekend, Dr. Howell?
Boy, I'll say, it was amazing. I spent 15 hours in that Museum of Natural History. I do love the Bacillosaurus and the Mastodons.
Aw, how fun! I'd love to stay and chat, but someone keeps hammer-paging me about this patient. So I'll go check on him. Have any of you been
on the wards recently?
No. Why do you ask, Dr. Billy?
Well, I think that you should go check it out. Mm-hmm.
The wards are in shambles! Did we get a new batch of interns already?
No! This is not your standard summer intern incompetence. We need to do something.
But where do we start?
Well, at the root cause.
What do you mean?
Okay, the only way to solve a problem of this magnitude is by going to the source and identifying the cause. It's time for a root cause analysis. Come on.
What's this? What's this?
There's fluids everywhere.
What's this?
Small bulbies in the air.
What's this?
I can't believe my eyes. There's people screaming. Where's the patient-centered care?
What's this? What's this? What's this?
There's something quite amiss.
What's this?
Not one wound has dehissed.
What's this?
They're gathering around to fix a murmur, sewing sternums with the wire.
Could this get any more dire? What is this? What's this?
There's doctors holding scalpels and standing over beds. They're busy placing drains in almost every patient's head. And BO on every door, oh, I can't believe my ears. Cause from the rooms I hear the cries of preoperative fears.
The tubes, the lines, they're everywhere. Who did these crimes? I've never felt like this before. This familiar world around me turned upside down. I simply cannot take more.
I want it back, I want it back, I want it for my own. I've got to know what is the root cause to be found.
What is this?
There are just too many problems. Ugh. I never thought I'd see the day when my dear fishbone failed me.
If we're gonna figure this out, we need to call the only group that surveys better than you, Jack.
Oh, you don't mean the...
I'm afraid so. It's time to call the Joint Commission!
Did someone say Joint Commission?
Attention all Michigan Medicine employees. The Joint Commission is on site! Please, at least pretend that you reviewed your unit's emergency preparedness plan. And for the love of God, wash your hands!
Members of the Joint Commission, as is custom before we begin another inspection, let us remind ourselves of our mission statement.
You better watch out, you better not cry, you better not shout, I'm telling you why. Joint Commission shutting you down.
That's definitely a Christmas song. I mean, you're all trying to tell me there's this kind of Christmas thing going on, but I see it. Oh, yeah. I see it.
I just love the smell of expired saline in the morning.
Is that non-regulation music I hear? You know Paul Fine's white coat compositions is the only music allowed in patient care areas.
Dr. Nalgene S. Calamari, you have been randomly selected for inspection.
It is Nazanin Esfandiari. And why wasn't anyone else randomly selected?
Well, is that a poster I see over there blocking the exit?
Oh, we've got him this time.
We're so excited to see you.
You are?
We are? Yes. Something terrible is going on, and we need your help figuring it out.
You'll see what we mean if you look behind that door.
That checks out.
But you didn't even look or do...
There's nothing suspicious going on over there. We should probably be going.
Well, does that at least mean we passed?
Well, we can forgive the medical errors and the nosocomial infections, but that visible water cup is a very serious offense. You fail.
No! This is a tragedy!
A tragedy unparalleled since the hiring of Irving Smokler as Assistant Dean of Student Affairs!
Well, I think our job here is done. See you when you least expect it.
The Joint Commission is as useless as those Friday SPOM lectures. China is closer to containing the coronavirus outbreak than we are to fixing the wards.
Boy, I sure do wish Dr. Cyril Grum's here.
You can say that again.
Boy, I sure do wish...
It's a figure of speech.
Well, I for one just don't get it. Medicine Land was always so jolly. What changed?
Well, I did just get a haircut.
No, that's not it. Although now that I think of it, we did have that strange visitor yesterday.
You're right. What was his name again?
I think it was Rishi Reddy.
That's it. Maybe he'll have some answers. I bet I know just where to find him.
Yeah. Who wants to see some pictures from me at the museum?
Oh, yes.
The lighting is terrible. They're all blurry and you can't see my thumb in half of them. But I promise the one good shot is worth it.
Tremper? The patient is moving. Table down. I said table down. Trimper, is he on another break? That's the 10th one in 30 minutes. Did you scrub in? You can't fool me. I know you didn't actually scrub in. Now go back and do it properly.
What does it even matter? It's not like your robots can get infected.
That's not the point. If you're going to be a surgeon, you have to learn how to do it properly.
I'm not... I have to talk to you about something.
I know what this is about. Dr. Hamoud called from the OB-GYN department and said you got a pass on your OB-GYN clerkship.
What? No, this is about Rishi.
It's about time you see things my way. That boy's a bad influence on you.
This takeover is going to be a disaster. These emergency medicine docs are about as reliable as a fundoscopic exam. They're going to capture Cyril Grum and take him straight to Perry Pernicano.
So what?
So? Somebody could get hurt?
What do you want me to do about it?
I don't know, anything. I'm going down to the radiology reading room to stop Pernicano.
I don't think so. You're not going anywhere wearing that.
Ugh, we can't just sit around. We have to do something.
Well, I forbid you from going down there. It's dangerous. What if the escalators are being repaired and you can't make your way back up?
What do you care? What do you care?
What did you say?
I said, what do you care?
You can't speak to me that way.
You never cared about me as a person. You'll never support me in the things that I want to do. You only care about the person that you want me to be.
How can you say that? I practically raised you since you were a first-year medical student.
Well, I'm not your M1 anymore. I'm not one of your robots, and I'm not going to be a surgeon. I'm going to be a pathologist, and a damn good one at that. And now, I'm leaving.
If you walk out that door, don't bother asking me for a letter of recommendation.
Okay, Boomer.
I'm serious about changing, young lady! There you are! You missed quite the performance from Miss Madelyn. That poor misguided child. I don't need 1,000x to see that her plan is foolish.
You know, I remember...
You know, I remember when a young woman who, like Madelyn, had to carve a path out for her own. It would be a lot easier with the support of a mentor, no? You should help her.
That is the most intelligible thing you've ever said.
Balls. Itchy.
Where are you going now?
Break.
Oh, fine! I don't need you! And I certainly don't need Madelyn! What would these people do without me?
Dr. Pranicano! Dr. Pranicano! We did it! We captured the medicine king!
Oh, splendid! Bring him in!
Grab him!
Come here.
Oh, yeah. Here he is, round, jolly man in red!
This is the Cyril Grum that everyone's been yammering on about?
Who are you? What are you doing with me?
I think the real question is, who are you?
I'm Kent Sheets, director of the family medicine clerkship and a staple at this medical school.
I bet the only thing you staple are those clerkship packets.
Enough, enough. I have no use for a man whose greatest achievement at this institution is being cast in the smoker every year. Let him go.
That was mean.
You three have some explaining to do.
We're sorry, Dr. Pernicano. There were seas of old white men out there.
What? We brought some more. Just let my coal go and grab me.
Avert your eyes, puny one-degree doctors! Do not gaze upon the glory of Eric Furon! Holder of 3 departmental appointments, as well as a named professorship. In addition to my wildly productive lab, I alone run the entirety of the cancer center. But wait, that is not all. Despite my many great accomplishments, first-year medical students still regard me as a star.
Hubba, that's the kind of silhouette I like to see.
Very impressive, Dr. Furon. Not as cool as my cloak, but... I can't respect a man who still uses Comic Sans in his PowerPoints. Begone, sir! You better hope this is the right one for your 3 sakes. You're Cyril Grum? Prove it. Say something only he would say.
Young man, if you want to succeed, you need to read.
He seems awfully cheerful for somebody who's just been kidnapped.
You know what? I don't buy it. No, I don't buy it. I've heard of this mythical Cyril Grum, and he's supposed to be a lot more adorable than you.
Adorable? You haven't read enough.
Get out. You're not him. There's the door.
Hello. I'm the real Cyril Grum.
He's still pretty cheerful for somebody who's just been kidnapped.
I know how we can wipe that...
Sam Hill is that?
We get these alerts from time to time. You'll get used to it.
right. Oh, I know how we can wipe that smile off your face. Kate, I need a drink. Well, well, well. Who's in my chair? Cyril Grum, huh? Oh, welcome to my lair. So you're the doc that Rishi's been on about. You're joking, you're joking. I mean, this can't be right. You're joking me, you gotta be. Why would students love this guy? I guess he is cute, but I don't know how it works. Must be handing honors out, cause I don't see the perks. When Dr. Pernicano says, add contrast to that scan, you get that ivy flowing sun, cause I'm the x-ray man. And when your patient's aching and you don't know what is wrong, I know you'll need my final read. Without it, you can't go on. Whoa.
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 Song. You're quite the character.
Seriously? I may have undercalled on my first impression. Dr. Grum, what would you say if I told you I kidnapped two internal medicine faculty and brought them here to be my own personal scribes?
Oh, I'd say go for it. We have over 50,000 faculty members.
Is anyone else getting strong cult vibes from this guy?
Let me take a shot at it.
Oh, Grum, what would you say if I ripped your beating heart out of your chest and donated it to the anatomy lab?
Dude.
Well, I'd definitely die. But at least it'd be in the name of medical student education.
Something not right there.
All right, Grum, I didn't want it to come to this, but you've left me absolutely no choice. Bring in the bonsai tree!
Oh, she's a... She's a beaut! Are you a member of the Ann Arbor Bonsai Society,
Dr.
too?
Dr. Cole, my gardening shears!
Oh, we're gonna trim? Oh, you sure know how to make a kidnapped guy feel welcome!
Well, I wouldn't say trim so much as chop!
Yes. No, you monster, please!
Yes, your screams are music to my ears! X-ray man.
I must be going back. Without my help, they all are sunk. The med students look up to me. To me, they don't come drunk.
You're joking, you're joking. I can't believe my eyes. Would someone narc this far enough? Besides, I've got my prize. I'm clever, I'm cunning. Thanks for lending me a pen. And now with a booming Grum decree, I'll keep them all past 10.
What are you gonna do?
Oh, I'm gonna school the best I can. Whoa! Nervous interpretations are music to my ears, cause I'm the teaching x-ray man whose lectures last for years. It's much more fun, I must confess, when students are engaged. So let me make them stay, or else your bonsai's out of days.
Release me now, or please at least don't harm another bonsai bough.
Oh, Cyril, you're senseless. You must not understand. I'm scared he's stroking out here, boys. Let's get a non-con scan. One final impression. Retire from patient care, cause I'm Perry Pernicano, and you ain't going nowhere. All right, now that I have your attention, are you prepared to meet our demands?
Anything.
We don't get the respect we deserve around here. Those surgeons in Procedure Town order imaging like it grows on trees. And what do we get in return? Nothing.
They don't even invite us to the anesthesia holiday party.
That's because you got drunk last year and puked in the autoclave.
Okay, but what do you expect me to do about it?
Our request, Dr. Grum, is humble. We would like the med students on radiology to stay past 10 a.m.
What? I have no control over your students.
Oh, I had a feeling you'd say that, but we have other plans for you.
You won't get away with this. I bet there's a whole floor of people looking for me right
now. Oh, I'm so scared! B1 is a labyrinth not even Magellan himself could navigate. You'll be down here for days. Now, let's have some fun, Dr. Grum. Wasn't it you who always said, when you think you're done, there's always one more snip to make?
No, please, please. Not the fungi tree. No.
Hey, it's me again. I just wanted to let everyone know that McKesson is back up. Carry on.
Hello?
I swear if you bring me one more coloring book, I will... Dr. Reddy, what are you doing here?
I came to see you. You looked horrible in your appointment with Dr. Sisson. They don't have any private rooms?
It's either this or a single on the family medicine service. So it could be worse. Oof.
Anyway, I was just gonna say, you look awful.
You were never one to sugarcoat things.
What are these medicine land docs doing to you?
They're giving me chemo. I don't understand all the medical jargon, but it's supposed to poison all of the bad cells and everything else, too.
That's barbaric. They might as well just give you a jewel laced with vitamin E acetate and a tall glass of Flint water.
You've always had the best jokes. That's why you're my favorite.
Anyway, what you need is more than...
Gara! How the heck are you, man? Yeah, I'm doing all right. They took a lot of skid. Oh, let me tell you. Good thing they did, though. It smells so bad down there. Oh, it was worse than the latrines back at NAM. Oh, worse than a landfill on a hot summer day. Remember that time your dog got skunked? Fido? Yeah, it's worse than that. Thank God they saved my dingle dangles, though. Oh, it's just so dang hard to
clean. Do you mind? We're trying to have a conversation here.
Gary, I gotta go. My roommate's being very rude. Give Sharon and the kids my best.
Anyway, as I was saying, if you just let me take you to the OR, I just think that we could just make... Oh, what now?
Therapy! Are you ready for your walk, Mr. Johnson?
Oh, yes, ma'am. Can you help me get up?
No, okay. No. This is painful. You know, I hear they're giving away free opioids in the cafeteria.
Mr. Johnson, up with the cyst! Up with the cyst!
Finally. Okay. Let me give this a shot. The medicine clearly isn't working. I know I can fix this.
Dr. Reddy, you saw my test results. What are you gonna do, remove all my organs?
If that's what it takes, I'm the best. I can connect any vessel, graft any lumen, transplant any organ.
What if that's not what I want?
If you just look at the skin...
You aren't listening
to
me.
No, you're the one who isn't listening to me. How can I show you that this is for the best?
Tell me something, girl. Are you happy in this chemo world? I can give you life. There's always indication for my knife. I'm trying to buy you time, cut the badness out, and save you from death. We can't accept that we're out of hope.
Something dark, why you always trying to beat the clock? Have you felt this pain? I felt so helpless as your hours wane. I try to make the best of what time I may have left for living. It's time to chase a different kind of home. I'm off the deep end, I think I'm dying. My time is running out. A crash car can save me, I'm saying this bravely. So Rishi, don't call me now.
DNAR, DNAR.
Patient.
I'm trying to save her. She doesn't want to be saved.
It was her time, Rishi. You did the right thing.
This has never happened to me before.
I know how you feel. But there are some things that no one, not even a surgeon, can fix. But you know what you probably could fix? That mess that's going on out there.
What do you mean?
You should take a look.
Okay, boss. Nothing to see here. Everything's totally fine.
I'm sorry, Dr. Hamoud. I've never done a pelvic exam before. The holes are so close together. I didn't mean to insert the speculum into the rectum.
So constipated. No Murlax for days.
They took everything. My appendix, my gallbladder, my dignity.
Oh, this is so much worse than I thought. Oh.
Help me! I have tubes everywhere! Everywhere!
How could I have been so wrong? I thought I could make things better around here, but I've made them so much worse. This experiment ends now. I gotta find a computer and page everyone to get back to Procedure Town.
No, please stop. I'm begging you. Just let me go.
Oh, Dr. Grum, you call that begging? I've heard med students beg more desperately for honors than you.
But I already told you, I have no control over the radiology curriculum.
Oh, it's such a shame. You'd be out of here so much sooner if you did.
Let her rip, Doug.
No. Yes! Sweet, I am essential. Please stop.
Give it another.
Pernicano, I knew something was up. What are you doing to this poor man?
Madelyn Lew, come to join the fun.
I came to stop you.
Oh, Madelyn. You know, you're always my favorite in this godforsaken town, but this is too much for a sweet, innocent soul like you. Why don't you just skedaddle?
I am sick and tired of the constant condescension. let Grum go before I report you to the Learning Environment Task Force.
Oh, before you report me to the Learning Environment Task Force. It's going to take a lot more than a vague third-party review to stop me. Now, where were we?
We were about to crush Groom's glasses between the mammogram plates.
That's right. Let's see how well you read without these.
Madelyn, is everything okay? I heard screams.
Karin Murazsko, how dare you set wheel in my reading room? You have some nerve.
This is a free hospital. I'll go where I please.
What are you doing here?
I came to help you.
Why?
When I was your age, there were very few women in academic neurosurgery. I had to carve a path out for myself alone. It would have been a lot easier with the support of a mentor.
That was beautiful.
Thanks. It just came to me. Madelyn, I've been a bad mentor.
I'm sorry, guys, but my nose really itches. If one of you could just...
Not now!
Well, I don't understand why you'd want to spend your time in the company of dead bodies. I respect that you're following your own path. You have my full support.
Thanks. And hey, at least I'll still be using a scalpel.
That's right, you will.
Oh, you two are so boring. What do you say we have some fun in here? Let's play pin the tail on the Cyril.
No, no more games. No more ridiculous yet surprisingly effective forms of torture. Let Grum go now.
Go, Maddie. Look at her go. That's my girl.
Not until our demands are met.
Yeah. What is it that you want? A new scanner? An invite to the holiday party? Friends?
Well, I may be a resentful radiologist who kidnaps and tortures complete strangers, but I'm not unreasonable. We here want the med students on radiology to stay past 10 a.m.
That's it? I should have asked sooner. I'll just add mandatory didactics so the students have to stay until 1:30.
Did we get him to add white balls to the vending machines?
No loss! Finally! I can already see the looks of unadulterated fear on their faces.
So you'll untie Groove now?
I am a radiologist of my word.
Oh, yippee!
Let's go, Madelyn. I refuse to spend another second in this depressing dungeon with these ingrates.
Something you'd like to share with the class, Murazsko?
Well, I guess there's nothing to lose now that we have a deal.
Don't.
The fact that you went through all this trouble just to get the students to stay an extra 3 hours is as much of a joke as your specialty. We don't need you. We never needed you.
She's right.
She is?
We did go through a lot of trouble for something so simple. Your side needs to sweeten the deal. Grum stays till we get the respect we deserve.
The medical school will lower tuition before I ever respect you.
Oh, stop it, you two. It's clear that you're never going to resolve this on your own. So, I invited David Belmonte from psychiatry to do some mediating.
Thank you very much for having me. Come on, you can join us. It's okay, this is a safe place. Now, I hear you two have been having some problems.
If by problems you mean mutual loathing, then yes, we have major problems.
Okay, now, how about we start by having Dr. Pernicano share how he feels?
She doesn't respect me or the work that I do. What I do requires a highly trained eye.
You tell her! Please! It's as easy as loading a dishwasher. But you also managed to flub by the looks of the one in the break room.
Cups go on the bottom rack and plates on the top. It's really not that hard, Murazsko.
See, Leslie, I told you.
Stay out of it.
Now, Dr. Murazsko, why is it that you don't respect this work?
What is there to respect? He just sits in a chair and looks at pictures all day.
Ha! You also sit in a chair all day.
Oh, that's real mature.
Okay. We need to find a more productive way to communicate this anger. Let's try this again. Now, Dr. Pernicano, how about you share how you feel, but using an I statement?
I feel disrespected when you disrespect radiology because I'm proud of what I do.
What I need is for you two to see that we're all on the same team.
Alan!
Pathology, radiology, we're essential diagnosticians. Surgeons need us to know where and what to cut. You can't accept me as a pathologist without accepting radiology, too.
But I
you know I'm right.
You know she's right.
You are right. How'd you get to be so smart? I have a great mentor.
Finally. I want to hear you say it. I want to hear you say you need my reads.
I need your reads.
I can't hear you.
I need your reads.
Yes! She's done it.
Well, it appears my work here is done. Thank you. Madelyn, will you tell Rishi Reddy what's happened here today?
I plan on it. But first, Pernicano, Leslie, Doug, Kate.
Ow. Is that Santa Claus? Am I in the naughty list again? Wait, you want to sit on Santa's lap?
Okay. This has gone too far. I mean, you're doing the Santa thing. There's a chair back here with skulls on it. I mean, if you're trying to confuse a guy, you're doing it. You're doing it. Doesn't it feel like we're in some kind of distorted world based off of a niche claymation kids film about Christmas and Halloween? You don't think so? We are not okay.
As I was saying, would you all care to sing with me?
Yeah. Let's hit it, boys.
The nurse wakes you at 7, and he draws your blood. You fill up all those tubes for the doctors who have never been.
Oh, sing it, Lou.
Downstairs, where they keep the stove, they go downstairs, where it stoves, no joke, they go downstairs, where the diagnostics are done. Down on B1,
down on B1.
Yes, you go
downstairs,
where my CT scan,
downstairs. They complain about our lifestyle, but the test expense
and how the hallways don't make sense.
Down on B1.
Skulls, all I do is look inside skulls. I keep thinking I've hit a lull, but my wife says, Doug, you're just dumb. Read that scan, man.
Downstairs,
my MR shirt, you work.
Downstairs,
where that contrast burns your work.
Downstairs, where you never hope to see sun. Down on B1. The beautiful, dysfunctional family. Now, who wants to get some froyo from the cafeteria?
Did you know you can blend the flavors?
Yeah, you can blend the flavors now. It's
hey, guys, where are you going? Could somebody untie me? Guys, I love froyo. No? Come on. I guess not. Well, that's okay, I guess. Oh, bonsai tree. Oh, bonsai tree.
How lovely are your branches. Oh, bonsai tree, oh, bonsai tree. How lovely are your branches. I'm all alone, strapped to this throne. I really just want to go home. Oh, bonsai tree. Yeah, I'm gonna die here for sure.
Welcome. Welcome. You're probably wondering why we gathered you all here today.
Yeah, this isn't one of those lunches where you give us mediocre Chinese food to hide bad news, is it?
No, the match day luncheon is in 2 weeks. They don't call this the nightmare before match day for nothing. No, this is the nightmare before match day. This is M&M take two.
Why? We never have anything to discuss at these things anyway.
Please tell me that's not another progress note.
I wish. This is a list of all the morbidity and mortality from the past 2 days. To say that Rishi Reddy's takeover was an epic failure would be a vast understatement. So to learn from our mistakes, we're gonna spend the next hour going through this stuff.
I love learning! Nerd!
Now, you all behave or you'll get a lump of coal in your dance goes.
And we're gonna remove all the candy corn from the team rooms.
Lump of coal? Candy corn? You're eating candy corn in February and you thought I wouldn't figure this out? Listen, people, this man is not Cyril Grum. His name is Dmitry Petrov and he is a KGB operative. They are using this transmitter to beam waves into your head so you can't see what I can. He is currently disguised as Santa Claus. Okay. They have infiltrated the North Pole.
Excuse me.
They have installed a doomsday device that, when activated, will trigger a cascade of events that will end humanity itself.
Hey.
Listen, people.
I
don't have much time. They're coming
would
for
someone
me.
Please
I know too
escort
much,
this man to the psychiatric emergency
Tell them
services?
My story.
Get
don't
him
eat
out of
the
here.
Candy corn!
Get him out of here!
Poison!
All right. Well. Back to the M&M. Who wants to present?
I'll go. My name is Rishi Reddy. I lost one of my most beloved patients during the takeover. She spent her final moments in pain because I couldn't accept the inevitable.
Jeez, that's a real downer. Would anyone care to lighten up the mood a little bit?
Yeah, how about something from our medicine land doctors?
I have something to share. Just the other day, one of my patients went into florid sepsis. I suspect the source was under a single layer of soiled gauze, but I was too afraid to check.
What the fuck?
Thank you for sharing. Does anybody have anything?
I have something to confess. When my patient with COPD became hypoxic after surgery, I tried to figure out what to do using my new Apple Watch from the MyPack study funded by the University of Michigan. But all I could do was tell him to use the incentive spirometer.
It's okay, Dr. Sonnenday. I recently learned that no surgeon can do it all. In fact, no one can. But I do think that we have skill sets that complement one another.
What are you saying, Rishi?
That we could provide a higher quality care if we work together. Each department could have a service dedicated to answering questions from other specialties.
That's not a bad idea.
Thanks. We could call it
Consult Force.
What about just consults?
Yeah. I mean, I thought my name was kind of cool, but that's fine. It's whatever.
Wait. So did I technically make a consult to Dr. Gibson when I asked him to prescribe me an SSRI?
Yes. You are the perfect example of how helpful consults can be.
Nothing scares me more than recurrent vaginal bleeding. Could I just get OB-GYN to handle that?
Yeah, by recurrent, do you mean monthly?
Yeah.
That's what I was afraid of. Not exactly. I don't think that that's a good...
Ooh, I'm a hospitalist. Can I consult everyone about everything?
Dr. Hartley, not exactly. That's not appropriate.
You know, I could really get behind this whole consult thing, Rishi. Dr. Sisson, you want to give it a try?
No.
Sure do. I can hear the consult now. Dear cardiology, can you help me fix this heart? His pulse is racing and his diastolic's off the charts. I haven't been into this patient's room in days, but I am pretty sure he's somewhere on 5A.
What? You haven't even seen the patient? They're gonna wanna know how the patient actually looks.
Okay, how about this? I need your presence.
No, who says that?
I need your guidance. He was stable through the night. If you come hold my hand, then everything might be alright. I'll take your advice, probably page you twice. We'll turn it around, wait and see. Cause all that we need is a little consultation. Appreciate Rex for a special situation. All you gotta do is call me, drop a note and smash. It's all a breeze. New consult, please.
This is a disaster.
My patient seems to be going into retention. I don't know how to put in a
fool. No, don't consult urology. Don't do it.
Dear urology, yes, I need your help with pee. His bladder is retaining, but I don't wanna touch his wee.
No.
And I have never placed a Foley cath before.
No.
So I don't ever wanna try one on the floor. So I'll count on you to push that Foley through. You'll turn him around, just make him pee.
Just make him pee. Psychology, help my patients going mad.
Dear gynecology, help my patients got a vag.
It's so great to consult for every small insult and work together every day.
Hey, 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 hey!
Cause all that we need is a little consultation. Appreciate Rex for a special situation. All you gotta do is call me, drop a note and snap. It's all a breeze. New consult, please. New console, please. New console, please. New console, please.
What have I done? This is a disaster.
Needs some work, but at least they've got spirit.
Thanks, Madelyn.
You know, I'd never thought I'd see the day that the great Rishi Reddy asked for help.
I guess he finally appreciates the diversity of talent in this place.
You know, Rishi's not the only one that gained an appreciation for his co-workers, is he?
Sure, but at least it didn't take an epically disastrous takeover and a dead patient for me to see the light.
Murazsko?
I'm kidding. I'm grateful for you, Tremper, and even Pernicano.
Me, proud, you, oh. I love all of you. I'm so proud of everyone. I told you we would create a massive movement together.
Even Dr. Pernicano seems to have let loose.
I don't know. I mean, who knew I didn't have the tolerance to drink with Kate Klein till 1:30?
Yes, it seems we all learned something valuable today. And if you ever try to do my job again, I will fucking end you.
Things are sure changing around here.
Yes, yes, yes.
From now on, our trust in one another guides the fight. From now on, we'll take our teams together to new heights. That starts tonight. Let this promise we make start for the patience in our hearts. From now on. From now on.
Mastered meds or surgeries, complacent to stay in our lane. But now it
it's easier to see the pitfalls of the dogs we became. We lost our peers along the years, the crazy price of always reading more.
And after all that's happened here, we'll remember what all this was for.
From now on, our trust in one another guides the fight. And from now on, we'll take our teams together to new heights. That starts tonight. Let this promise we've made start, for the patience in our hearts from now on.